Hi everybody, this video is to inform you that by watching what I'm about to show you in the Korean Ninjutsu system, not only are you going to learn my system, but I'm also indirectly going to teach you other systems as well. So it's my hope that you benefit from learning two systems of ninjutsu and making a fair comparison. Now, if you expect me to be polite about it after people have attacked the women, I'm not going to do that. I'm actually going to tell it like it is, and hopefully through all of this you could actually find or improve on techniques and systems, and how you can incorporate this into your life and make it work for you. Like I said, I'm not going to be as humble, but I'm going to be very bold and blatant about comparing my Taekwondo Hapkido. Your great ninjutsu. Okay guys, I'm going to show you other ninjutsu or systems that they claim that they teach, and this is a front breakfall. They have a triangular hand position, some of them, and other things, but what they fail to, and I think it's important for you guys that wants to develop in the Korean ninjutsu, is when you're doing front falls, the basic is just like slapping the ground and making sure that you use your whole entire arm rather than using an elbow or a wrist to prevent injury. But the actual insur technique is you throw out the weak hand right in front of you towards the neck area, and then your strong hand goes right on top of it, and then you break your fall like this. And the reason is need your strong hand, because this hand is usually carrying a sword, or it needs not to be injured. If you do this, you're going to scrape or injure possibly both hands when you have sharp objects on the ground. So you always sacrifice the weaker hand and keep your strong hand on top. That way you can preserve it. Now, the other reason why you need your strong hand not to be injured is, you think kanjas or ninjas don't do a lot of climbing with their hands, you're absolutely wrong. Now, if you are wearing any climbing equipment, you do not put your hands on top, but you throw both down for the obvious reasons. So let me demonstrate. Their way, or other systems, they'll take a triangular position, turn their hand, and bring fall like this. But if you don't have any hand balls or equipment, you place it on top and you like this. Very important that this stays in front of your neck, because you don't want anything sharp on the ground to stab you in the neck area. So it's like this. Now for you left-handers, with the left strong hand, you might want to sacrifice the right or the left. And that would be the correct way for the Korean ninjutsu insur system, okay?